Hello friends, let me introduce myself. I am Soil and I play an important role in all your lives. I am responsible for providing nutrition and water to the plants. I provide support to the trees and I am very important for agriculture. I have a lot of water and also small worms in me. These also help plants and crops grow. Only if I am of good quality, you all will eat good grains, vegetables, fruits, nuts, etc. It takes thousands of years for me to form, and I have a long story. To share my story, I shall take you to a village in Jharkhand and introduce you to Babul and Babu. We will learn the various aspects of soil in this video.
Babul, Babul, come here.
What do you want, brother?
I wanted to help Baba in making these masks out of mud. However, there are small pebbles in this. Can you pick the pebbles from the mud?
Brother, why don't you sieve it? I think that way pebbles will get separated easily.
That's a good idea. I don't know why I didn't think of it. Get the sieve and please separate pebbles from the mud.
I will just come.
Whenever Baba gets mud, it is soft and nice. I wonder how pebbles came into it this time. Looks like the mud has come from a different place.
While children are preparing masks, can you enlist the things you find in soil?
Babul, these masks are complete. Soft mud is also over. Father was asking us to make a few lamps.
Where do we get the mud from? There is no soft mud around.
Go, ask father and come.
Okay, brother. Brother, father is saying that we can go to Ramnath Chacha's house and get the soil.
Come, let us go. Look, I can see Parimal Bhaiya. Good afternoon, Bhaiya. Why is this machine here?
Babul and Babu, what brings you here?
Bhaiya, father has sent us to get clay. But why is the machine here?
Oh, this is a drill machine.
What is this used for?
Our well has got dry and we are having water problem. So father is getting the ground drilled.
What will happen with this?
They will keep a hand pump so that we can use the water.
Oh, but I don't see any workers here.
They are sitting down. They drilled the ground a lot, but they found hard rock and they could not drill further. They will get another machine to break the rock.
A big rock! I thought there is only soil in there. When I dig to plant at our house, I do not find any rocks. Look at the heap of mud besides the hole. Look at its composition. It is brown, reddish, and then it is also light brown.
Very intelligent observation. Can anyone tell me how soil is formed? I am sure you have learnt about this in your previous classes.
I have just studied that due to sun, rains, moisture, big rocks break into smaller pieces and into further pieces, and that is how soil is formed. It takes thousands of years for the soil to form.
Brother, when we were sieving the mud, pebbles were found. Do you remember?
Yes, you are right. Soil is formed due to the breakage of big rocks into smaller ones, and then it slowly becomes soil. This happens due to the influence of sun, rain, wind, etc., and it is called weathering. However, even on the upper surface, you will find some pebbles, sand, etc. The heap you are seeing here is the different layers of soil.
Oh, I see.
Soil is made of distinct layers. Come, I will explain about the soil profile, that is, how these layers are arranged.
Brother, let us see what Parimal Bhaiya is saying.
I will get a bottle and a glass of water.
Okay, Bhaiya.
Look, I have got a transparent bottle and in this I am putting a handful of mud. And I am adding a glass of water. Now observe, what do you see?
See, the pebbles in the soil are settling down.
Correct. So this is just a sample. You keep this overnight, the clarity is even more.
Oh, I can see the differentiation here too. There are small stones at the bottom and then there is sand.
Absolutely correct. Then you have silt and finally the soft mud. On top, can you see the organic matter? This is called humus, which feeds the plants.
Is the soil profile under the earth like this?
Yes, your guess is right. There are distinct layers of soil in the earth. Topmost layer is called topsoil. This has humus.
I know. Plants grow on this.
The next layer below is called middle layer. It has minerals.
Then are there rocks after this?
This layer has small rocks and the last layer is bedrock.
Which layer of soil contains water?
The topmost layer contains water, sand, and gravel at the bottom help the water to get drained so that the roots do not get rot.
Bhaiya, as there is organic matter in humus and it helps soil, can we also add good things to the soil?
What do you plan to do?
I plan to dig the soil a little and add dry leaves, fruit peels, vegetable peels, etc. I'm sure it will help soil.
Yes, you are correct. We should put only organic matter and not plastic and other artificial things in the soil. This will spoil the soil.
Thank you, Bhaiya.
Please give us the clay. We shall take your leave.
Sure.
Children, in this video, we learned about the various aspects of soil and also learned about the soil profile. In the next video, we will learn about the types of soil.
The Story of Soil Part 2. Hello children, I hope now all of you would have understood that soil is an important natural resource. Do you know about the different layers of soil? Alright, tell me what is the topmost layer of soil known as? Correct, it is humus, which is made up of dead and decaying matter. I have a question in my mind and I'm looking for an answer. Is the soil similar at all the places? And is the soil different at riverbeds, gardens, etc.? Let us go and look for the answer in village where two children are in conversation about the same question. The objectives of this story are to know about the types of soil and to understand about the qualities of soil. This is Neelu and that is Meenu. Both of them had planted a plant in two different pots. Neelu's plant had become lush and green. However, Meenu's plant did not grow much and had no fresh green leaves. They were discussing about the same.
Oh, Neelu, look, my plant is drying up. I put enough water, kept it in the sunlight, and there is enough air also here. Yet it is dry.
Yes, Meenu, I was thinking the same. I kept my pot in the sunlight, gave enough water, manure like you did. What difference was there between your way and mine? Let us water our pots and see what happens.
The girls first water Neelu's pot and then Meenu's pot.
Look, Meenu, the water is seeping slowly in the soil. Some water is still in the pot. It will slowly seep in. Come, let us water your pot now. Let us now water your plant. Oh, look, Meenu, the water seeped in the soil of your pot quickly.
Neelu, do you remember you took the soil for your plant from Ramu Kaka's garden? I used the mud from the sandy soil lying outside the house.
Yes, Meenu. Come, let us do an experiment. To solve our question, let us take the soil from three different places and put water in it and observe what happens.
Meenu and Neelu take three utensils. Then they walk towards Ramu Kaka's garden to collect some soil. They collect some sandy soil and they take a third sample of soil from Shankar Kaka's field. On returning home, they put the different samples in the three different utensils.
Come, Meenu, let us now pour equal quantity of water in all the three.
They pour water in all the three samples but could not understand much.
Neelu, I think we have to try something else. This did not help us to observe much.
I have an idea, Meenu. Let us make funnels out of thick paper. I had learned how to make them in my science class in grade 6. Then we will put the different samples of soil through the funnel into used plastic bottles. We shall place a deep container or plate beneath it. Then we shall pour equal quantity of water in them. I think by doing so, we will be able to see which soil sample soaks more water.
I shall go and get three plastic bottles. Mother kept a few away yesterday.
Okay, I will make the funnels. Okay, everything is ready. Now let us put this sandy soil through the first funnel. And the soil from the garden in the second. And similarly, the soil from Shankar Kaka's field in this third one.
Meenu puts the different samples through the different funnels. Then Neelu pours water onto them. Then the girls wait for some time.
Look, Neelu, a lot of water has passed through this sandy type of soil. I had observed that in this soil, the loose sand particles were more, but the soil we picked from Shankar Kaka's field was very sticky and wet.
Yes, I think it is a correct observation. I observed that the soil we picked from the garden had an almost equal quantity of big and small particles.
Nilu, look, the soil we picked from Shankar Kaka's field let very little water pass through, and this sample from the garden allowed some water to pass, and some is still there on the top.
Yes, Meenu, you are right. So does it mean that the plants which grow in the sandy type of soil need less water, but the plants which grow in the soil we picked up from the garden need optimum water?
Oh, Shankar Kaka's fields have rice sowed, and I remember Baba had said that a lot of water is required for the cultivation of rice. So, I think that type of soil would not allow a lot of water to seep through, like we just observed in the experiment.
I remember I had read that deserts have loose sand, and that is the reason very few plants grow there. Like we just saw that the sandy type of soil let water pass through quickly. So, I think the plants would be getting less water.
And this soil from the garden soaks the optimum amount of water and lets the extra water pass to the roots.
Meenu, you also used sandy type of soil, remember?
Yes, Nilu.
The sandy type of soil does not retain water. Your plant wasn't getting enough water and therefore it wasn't growing well. And my plant had soil from the garden, and hence it was using enough water. Hence it grew well.
This means that according to the size and quantity of particles found in soil and the spaces between them, we can categorize the soil. My teacher had once mentioned that cotton, vegetables need optimum water, and rice and sugarcane need a lot of water. Hence, they need different soil.
Yes, according to what she told you and our experiment, we can say that there are different types of soil. According to the size of particles found in soil, we can divide soil into sandy soil, clay soil, and loamy soil.
Hey Meenu, you are talking just like a teacher. Just a pair of glasses is missing.
Meenu, what do you think? What kind of soil does Shammu Kaka use to make the pots he makes?
Let us go and find out.
So friends, both the girls did such an interesting experiment. I found the answer to my questions. We can divide soil into three types. Sandy soil, it has more loose particles. Clay soil, it is sticky and has small particles. Loamy soil, it has a balance of small and big particles. Now I also want to know, like Nilu, that which kind of soil is used to make pots, etc. We will meet soon in the next video. The Story of Mud, Part 3. In the previous video, you had learned about the soil properties. Soil is the elixir of life. Without soil, trees and plants cannot grow, nor can a farmer cultivate. We also learned that there are minerals, stones, insects, etc. in the soil. In this video, we will learn some more aspects of soil. Let me take you to Wayanad in Kerala. Here Biju is playing in the mud with his sister Sheena. The objective of this video is to know about soil moisture and water absorption capacity by different types of soil.
There is so much fun playing in mud.
And look, I brought some sand too.
Let's build houses from this sand and make dolls with clay.
Look here, Biju. A house made of sand is crumbling again and again. There is not much wetness in this sand. Add some more water. Let us see if this makes the house stronger.
Let me try adding some water, because if it becomes too wet, like clay, then this sand house will get spoiled.
Look, Biju, what a nice sand house I made.
Children, come early and have dinner. You both have to go out in the evening.
Come on, Biju, mother is calling. Wow, what a nice toy model you made out of the clay.
How sticky the hands have become. Let's wash them with soap. I shall keep this toy with your sand house to dry. Sheena, your sand house broke again. And look here, there is no moisture in this sand. Looks like that was the reason the house broke again.
Your toy is not broken, Biju. But look, this toy is also drying up. It seems the moisture is running out.
You are right. They were both in the sun. The sand house broke down and my toy is still drying.
You must have noticed that when it rains, our yard becomes wet and after a few hours, everything dries up.
Does this mean there is moisture in the soil? Does this moisture dry out due to sunlight or heat?
Yes, there is moisture in the soil.
Come on, children, rest a while. You have to go to the flower shop in the evening.
Come, let us go inside. Mother is calling.
While the children are resting, we shall perform a small experiment. Take two glasses, put some soil in both of them. Keep one glass aside. Take another glass and boil it for a while. What do we see?
Kids, get ready soon. The flower show is open only till 8 o'clock.
Father, we are coming. Hurry up, Biju.
Father, today we were playing with mud. We made a toy out of clay and we also made a sand house. But we saw that our sand house broke and the clay toy almost dried up. Why would this have happened?
Soil contains water. This causes moisture in the soil. Just as we need water, the soil also needs water.
Trees and plants grow, isn't it?
Yes, plants get nutrients due to the water in the soil.
Due to water, trees are green and vegetables, fruits and flowers also grow, isn't it, Father?
Yes, through water, plants get dissolved nutrients such as nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, and calcium, etc., which reach their roots. Then the plants get nourishment from the roots. Look, we have come to the flower show. Here you will find different flowers, plants, seeds.
Wow, look at these beautiful flowers!
And see how many different varieties of plants are there here.
You both stay here. I will just come.
Biju, look at this. All these flowers are looking so beautiful.
Sheena, something is written here.
It is written here that these flowers have grown in different types of soil.
Hello children, my name is Cosmos Flower. And do you know I grow in sand?
This flower is talking.
You know, the sandy soil in which I bloom doesn't have enough water absorption capacity. Therefore, a lot of air is present in this type of soil. It's hard for me to grow. Well, yet I try. Look how beautifully I grew. That is why I have been exhibited in the flower show. Children, would you like to take me home?
The water holding capacity of the soil of this flower is very less. This flower is so beautiful and it does not need much water. I want to take this flower home.
Children, you look at me. I bloom from early spring to mid-summer. I bloom in various colors, from white to pink, red and yellow. You know, I bloom in clay. The water holding capacity of this soil is very high. You can also make toys with this wet clay. This soil is present everywhere. Take me home. This soil is rich in organic materials.
This flower is nice too, but its soil water holding capacity is quite high. So this flower needs more water. Biju, shall we take it home?
Children, I'm the best. The soil in which I bloom is called loamy soil. This soil consists of sand, clay and silt. It also contains enough humus. Its water holding capacity is good, not more and not less. This soil gets enough air. It is well suited for farming. Due to this soil, the roots of plants get enough space for water, air and growth. I also bloom everywhere. Take me home.
Oh God, there is a fight between these flowers. What to do, Biju? Where is father? Let us ask him.
To whom were you two children talking to?
We weren't talking to anyone, father. We are unable to decide. So, you tell us which of these three flowers you liked. We will take the same flower home.
I liked all three. Let's take these three home.
Was there less fighting amongst us?
Children, in this video, you have learned about moisture in soil and water holding capacity of different soils. Hope you have liked this video. In the next video, you will learn about soil and crops. See you! The Story of Soil Part 4. Hello children, how are all of you? I had gone on a journey in a train. I saw a few northern states of India like Punjab, Haryana and Uttar Pradesh. The diversity in the languages is similar to the different types of soil found in the region. The green fields of Punjab, the cotton fields of Haryana and the rice fields of Uttar Pradesh were all wonderful. It is amazing, isn't it? Why are different types of crops grown in different places? Is there any relationship with the soil of the region? Let us find out about it with the characters of this video, Neelu and Meenu. The objectives of this video are 1. Different types of crops grown in different types of soil. 2. Water, air and rain impact the quality of soil. Meenu has returned from her grandma's village yesterday. She goes to visit her best friend Neelu.
How are you, Meenu? When did you come back from your grandma's village?
I came back yesterday.
I heard of a flood in that village.
Yes, Neelu, but there was no destruction. The level of the river had risen due to heavy rainfall. But you know, Neelu, because of the heavy current of the river, the soil around it was swept away. Grandma was telling me that the soil around the riverbed is very fertile.
Yes, true. A lot of green vegetables grow around the river.
Yes, the soil near the riverbed is wet and sticky, while the soil around us is sandy. But what is the reason for this?
I think the climatic changes impact the soil. Like I have observed that the soil dries up if it does not rain, isn't it?
My grandma said that because of the fast flow of the river, the soil also gets carried away along with the water and gets collected on the riverbed.
Meenu, I have an idea. Let us do an experiment to understand this.
What kind of experiment, Neelu?
Let us take some soil and make a small mountain. Out of it, we will then pour a glass full of water on it. We had studied that rivers flow from mountains to plains.
Meenu and Neelu go outside and make a small mountain.
Let us now pour water over this mountain we made.
Look, Neelu, the water is flowing down and is taking the soil along with itself.
Let us wait for some time. Look, Meenu, the soil which had come along with the water is getting collected near the water.
Oh yes, I think in the same way, due to the strong current in the river, a lot of soil gets carried away and it settles near the riverbed. And the river passes through so many places. So I think it collects the different types of soil from there.
Oh, that is why the soil along the riverbed is so fertile.
Neelu, my mother had asked me to buy fruits. Come, let us go to the market.
Look, Meenu, the soil here is so red.
Yes, Neelu, you know, the soil in my grandma's village was black.
Why is it that in some places the soil is red, at some brown and at others black?
Nearby, a farmer was working in his field when heard the girls talking and looking for answers.
Children, there are certain minerals present in the soil, like iron, etc. And because of these, the color of the soil differs. The soil in our village is red because of high iron content.
Is it, Kaka? We have read about the different types of soil, but did not know that the minerals present in the soil impact its color. My grandmother was telling me that the soil in her village was black because of the presence of deposits due to volcanic activity many years ago. The soil was also very fertile.
This is so interesting. I want to know more, Meenu. After buying the fruits, let us go and look for a book on this in the local library.
Both the friends buy fruits from the market and go to a nearby library.
Look, Neelu, here it is. The name of the book is Soil, Our Resource.
Look, it is written here that in some parts of India like Guntur in Andhra Pradesh and Maharashtra, the soil is black because of the volcanic ash. This type of soil is very fertile. The crops which grow here are pineapple, cotton and lemon.
Kaka told us about the minerals in soil due to which the soil can be red and it is black because of the volcanic ash.
This means that different type of soil is suitable for different crops.
Oh, that is the reason. I could see different types of crops cultivated at different places when I travelled by train. Some places had wheat and some cotton.
So it means that for different crops, different type of soil is required. Come, Meenu, let us go home and make a list of which soil is suitable for which crop. Then we shall show it to our teacher tomorrow.
Both the friends reach home and make a list. Friends, why don't you all also make a similar list?
Look, Neelu, the fruits that I bought must have grown in different regions.
Yes, I grow in colder regions like Himachal Pradesh. I need sandy and loamy soil.
And children, I will grow well in places with adequate sun and moisture like Andhra Pradesh, Maharashtra, etc. I grow well in loamy and sandy soil.
Meenu, do you think that natural calamities like floods, volcanoes help in making the soil fertile? Tomorrow when we show this list we made to the teacher, let us ask her the answer to this question also.
So children, did you observe that different types of soil like sandy, loamy soil are appropriate for wheat and gram? Similarly, the correct soil type is essential for the cultivation of particular crop. I also got the answer to the questions I had. Now I understand that farmers grow crops according to the soil. We will meet soon with our next video.